Vana Eliezer, whom we have proudly chosen to bring the Thanksgiving message on this significant occasion. When I was in middle school, she was the head girl of the school. We knew her as Vana Kumarasamy, winner of many oratorical contests, an astute student, a chorister, an actor, an all-rounder. She's the daughter of Reverend Raja Kumarasamy, our parish priest at St. John's Church, Chundikuli, and Mrs. Pavalam Kumarasamy, a brilliant teacher at Chundikuli. Many of us present here have been blessed by their service to the community. Vana completed her primary and secondary schooling at Chundikuli Girls College. Vana went on to enter Kalamba University to read for an English honors degree. She eventually returned to Chundikuli to teach before her life took her on a journey across the seas to Cambodia, where she served as a CMS missionary for more than 20 years. Given that Chundikuli was founded by CMS missionaries, it is fitting that one of our best would go on to share these blessings in another country. May God abide in the words and thoughts of Vana as she brings the Thanksgiving message for us today.
It's my delight and joy to be here today. Thank you to the committee who invited me to share God's message. My standing here itself is an acknowledgement of what God has done in my life, and it's an act of thanksgiving. However, having listened to all these stories, I cannot help but to share something of my A-level days, briefly. That's to do with Mrs. Champion. Who can organize a function in the Chundikuli days without consulting Mrs. Champion? Miss Ethna Kori Vettavanam Noor Berg. Ethna Chunda Arasi Vanam. We used to plague her, we used to go after her whenever we had to organize functions, dinners. And we are thankful to the many teachers who shaped us. We are thankful to God who taught them. We're not all cleansed. Where are the nine? Words of Jesus. In this story that was read to us by Anna, Jesus is heading towards Jerusalem and traveling along the border between Samaria and Galilee. Luke, the historian, mentions the route to highlight that this was a location where the Samaritans and the Jews, who had little to do with each other, still lived as neighbors. Hence, it's not a surprise that one of the lepers was a Samaritan. People afflicted by leprosy during that time were totally ostracized from society. In fact, those with any form of skin disease had to be either quarantined or go into self-isolation as required by the Jewish priests. They had to be in lockdown, to use another of those terms that have become so familiar to us in recent times. The difference then was there was no hospitals and they had to live in caves or some faraway place uninhabited by humans, except by their very community of lepers. The relatives would go and leave their food and wait and watch from a distance. Some of you may have seen this enacted in the movie Ben-Hur. Even more heartbreaking was that whenever the lepers had to come out of their abode, they had to shout, "Unclean, unclean," to warn the others. If the distance is not kept, they had to risk stoning or death. It is such a place that Jesus and his disciples chose to pass through. Let me invite you to walk with me through this story to follow the three stages of these 10 lepers. First, they come to Jesus together. Then, they go together on Jesus' word. Thirdly, the surprise part. They separate. Only one returns to Jesus. Coming together, going together, separation. And only one returns. First, they come together to Jesus. The 10 lepers catch wind that this compassionate Jesus, who has been healing the sick in miraculous ways, is passing their way. They have never met him before, but they are desperate. So wishfully, yet boldly, they come out to him. Observing the required social distancing, they cry out, "Jesus, Master, have mercy on us." Jesus hears their cry from afar and responds, "Go, show yourselves to priests." There's no uncertainty in his tone. Jesus knows what they need is much more than mere physical healing. They needed to be integrated back into society, their dignity lifted up. No longer they need to be outcasts, a stigma unfairly imposed upon the society, upon them by the society. So he simply commands them to go and show themselves to the priest so that they are pronounced fit for their re-entry into community life. What about us? In our lives too, when we need help, we cry out to Jesus. Especially so, now that we know that he is God incarnate and risen from the dead, he hears our cries. I'm sure that the late Mr. Alfred Hensman and other parents in the 1890s would have cried out to God regarding the welfare of their daughters. As we know, the women at that time were treated as somewhat second-class citizens and were disregarded when it came to education, among other privileges. What a blessing Chundikuli Girls School has been to each one of us and is continuing to be so for the people of Jaffna. The ten cry out, Jesus hears their cry and responds. He still does. He is our loving God who is always ready to yield to our cries and to bless us. Secondly, they go together on Jesus' promise. The 10 lepers take Jesus at his word and obediently, yet slowly, they walk back into the community from which they had been ostracized. They're not sure if they will be stoned or not, but still they walk on towards the priest's house. But even before they go very far, they begin to feel something different. Wow, yes, their skin is turning to normal. The penny drops. They are healed. Masks come off. Aren't they amazed? They take the risk and obey. Jesus heals them as they obey. Healing comes in their obedience, not before. Another example to illustrate the power of God's word, Jesus' words. The Roman centurion, a non-Jew, comes to Jesus pleading for the life of his servant who is battling with death. The centurion said, "Jesus, don't trouble yourself. You don't have to come that very far to my house. You don't need to come to my home. Just say a word." His faith was rewarded. At that very moment, the servant was healed. Another one. "Lazarus, come out!" This was the voice of Jesus. His word that raised Lazarus of Bethany from death to life. The dead man buried in the tomb for 4 days was raised by the voice of the Creator God. The word of God comes in different ways and for different purposes and in different contexts. I'm sure we have all experienced that. Mary Carter, our founding principal, obeyed the call of Jesus. Chundikuli Girls College was and is the answer to the cry of late Mr. Hinsman and other parents who had daughters stuck at home. And it has continued to be a blessing through all those who have selflessly served. So now, 125 years later, today, we can celebrate this moment and give thanks to the one through whom all blessings flow. Thank you. Already stole my thunder. Count your blessings you have received through Chundikuli. Thirdly, the 10 lepers, their separation. The root of joy is gratefulness, says the founder of global gratefulness. It's not joy that makes us grateful, but it is gratitude that makes us joyful. Let me tell you about the experience of Chan, a 28-year-old young woman, a Cambodian woman. When Chan called the pastor of our Cambodian church and asked for an appointment to meet with him and with us, in part my husband and me, we were not sure what her agenda was. We had known Chan for her from her teenage days. Chan surprised us by saying, "Oh, Lukru, I have received much from the Lord and I want to give back to him." We were all silent. We were still trying to guess. And she continued, "God gave me many opportunities, such as studying English, part-time job as a uni student, learn new skills, something very special for Cambodians. All these I received freely, so I want to give back. I want to serve him." We were dumbfounded. Our experience with people from similar background as Chan was that they wanted handouts, but Chan was different. Chan's burden was to have a drop-in center for her neighborhood kids to educate them, kids who sell flowers to earn their living. She herself was raising funds for this purpose by selling pickles. After much prayer and discussion, we agreed to work together. Today, Chan's joy is greater as she heads up a local community organization serving disadvantaged youth and their families. Her heart of thankfulness has brought her joy. Let's get back to our journey with 10 lepers. They continue to walk and now perhaps beginning to imagine or anticipate the warm embrace of their loved ones and perhaps planning a party with the family. Those of us in Victoria may recall how we used to wait for the daily government announcements of easing restrictions and start planning our visits and gatherings or a nice conjure. But one of the 10 starts running back to Jesus. This man is different. His thoughts are different. His heart is full of gratitude. And he turns around, for he knows who healed him. So he rushes back. He wants to take a closer look at the man who healed him from afar, the source of his blessing. He wants to acknowledge the one who healed him. He wants to pour out his heart of gratitude to say, "Thank you." Above all, he wants to hear the voice of this man again. He wants to know Jesus. Once a helpless cry, now a cry of praise, both triumphant and joyful. The root of joy is gratefulness. Thanksgiving opens the door to greater blessing. Give thanks in all circumstances, says the Apostle Paul. "Where are the other 9? Asked Jesus. "Where indeed are they?" "At the priest's house? Or at the temple? Or at a party?" It's not that it's much of a surprise to Jesus, but he's not shy of stating the contrast. 1 out of 10. And in fact, this one is a foreigner. And it is the Jews who are quick to boast of God Almighty's historical interaction with them. Jesus publicly acknowledges the faith of the foreigner, the Samaritan whom the religious Jews had little to do with. It is that very heart of gratitude that Jesus saw as evidence of true faith, a faith that led the man to break away from the peer pressure. Friends, we see that the Samaritan goes home with a richer dignity and fullness of joy, assured and affirmed by the one who healed him, for he has met with Jesus individually, one to one, something the other 9 miss out on. They separate, one man returns, Jesus reveals himself to the man, affirms his faith, and sends him home filled with joy. It can be our own experience too. Gratitude may be demonstrated in many ways. Like this one man, it can be expressed in worship, praise, and adoration of the one who gives, or we can become an instrument in the hands of God, or voice of God, as was in the case of missionaries at Chundikuli, or the teachers and others, or like Mr. Hensman. For the girls of Chundikuli and Jaffna, we can be agents. We thank God for all those who have served, continue to serve at the school or through alumni group like ours. Jesus asked, "Were not all cleansed? Where are the other 9? The 10 cried. Jesus heard their cry and responded. He still does. They took the risk and obeyed. Jesus healed them as they obeyed. Healing comes in their obedience. They separated. One man returned. Jesus revealed himself to the man, affirmed his faith. That one person went with a newfound level of dignity and greater joy, for he had connected with the one who is the source of all blessings. Where are the other 9? Did Jesus not know where they were? Not really. Why did Jesus ask? He knew what they were missing out on. Jesus is also causing his audience with him at that time to consider the fate of the 9, and thus causing us to consider our own lives, whether we are counted among the 9 or identified with the one who returned. The root of joy is gratefulness. It is not joy that makes us grateful, but it is gratitude that makes us joyful. It is gratitude to the giver of all good things. May God bless these words.
Thank you. Gracious God, we give thanks as we celebrate the 125th anniversary of the Chundikuli Girls College and the journey that started so many years ago. We celebrate all the joys, all the happy times, all the accomplishments, and all the triumphs. Thank you, Lord, for all the blessings. We acknowledge that there have been and will continue to be struggles and heartaches. Yet we have traveled together under your protection and love. Thank you, Lord, for being with us in good times and bad. We ask, Lord, that you would continue to protect the school, the students, staff, and past people. Guide and sustain them as we go forth from this 125th anniversary commemoration. Gracious God, as we celebrate our past and rejoice in our present, we also look forward with eager eyes to the future. We pray that you would continue to make your love known among us, blessing and guide Chundikuli Girls College as she continues to serve the community. May the knowledge imparted, wisdom gained, and friendships formed honor you and make our world a better place. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all evermore.
Jordan flows before us.
Zion beams with light. May we go forward through the darkness, forward into light.
Thank you. call the teachers of Chundikuli Girls College, those who have been teachers during this time. So we'll first call Mrs. Champion. Mrs. Champion. Arundhi Lanchar. And Vana Eliezer. Vana Eliezer. This is Chandra Amala Singh. And Daisy Ratnaraja.